and watch us where we go.
Pinalang kaadlaw before mag-Christmas, no? And I'm sure you're excited about that. And once again, we're so happy that we can also celebrate Family Sunday, subong Domingo, no? And I hope and pray nga dako sa kompleto nga family, no? You will have a special prize, no? Kung kompleto ka mga family. Okay, so shall we all stand as we welcome one another, as we sing our welcome song? Okay, welcome to the family.
Welcome to the family. We're glad you have come. Share your life with us as you grow in love. And may we always be to you what God would have us be. The family always there to be strong and to lead on. May we learn to love each other more with each new day. May words of love be an abyss in everything we say. May the Spirit melt our hearts and teach us how to pray, that we might be a true family. Welcome to the family. We're glad that you have come to share your life with us as we grow in love. And may we always be to you what God would have us be. A family always there to be strong and to lead on. May we learn to love each other more with each new day. Love as we grow in love. And may we always be to you what God would have us be. A family always there to be strong and to lead on. To be strong and to lead on. To be strong and to lead on.
So welcome especially sa ating mga bisita. Although from time to time, ari man na sila. We would like to welcome, first of all, Mr. Engineer Gonzalo Rodriguez. Sir, well, and also, gina-welcome ko man ang Kimpo Clan. Happy to have Auntie Puring with us, ang isawa. Ah, Auntie Suling, sorry, sir, Auntie Suling, no? And then we have there, Engineer Jesse, si Engineer Lester, kang ilang family. Pwede ka mo makatindog. Hindi na ko mag-recite sa inyong alam. Okay, kadaan mo na sa ila. I belong to family. And we're so happy to have you with us. Kaya look forward for a great reunion again this season. So welcome, Git. Welcome, Git. No? Okay, may CPJ Aranyador. Of course, we're so happy to have you again. No? Salamat, Git. No, yeah. Masako nga tao. And so from time to time, makabisita din sa atin si Engineer Gonzalo Rodriguez. Okay, may ibang tagid ng mga first-timers, mga bisita nga, why to ma-welcome. So I hope and pray, no, nga, you will have good hearts and minds even as we come to worship the Lord.
fourth candle of Advent reminds us of the light of the Star of Bethlehem that led the wise men to the Christ child and still leads us today.
Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 2. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who had been born king of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him."
Matthew chapter 2, verses 9 to 12. After they have heard the king, they went on their way, and the star that they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. On verse 10, when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. When they opened their treasures and presented him with gold, gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Let us pray. Make us ready through the Holy Spirit, O God, for the coming of another Christmas, that we may put away all sinfulness, the knowing grudges, the petty quarrels, the perennial jealousies and prejudices, until our hearts are opened to welcome once again the babe of beauty, joy, peace, and truth. Help each of us to see our Bethlehem and to behold the star of light and wonder, that we may humble ourselves and hear the angels sing to us in spite of our busyness these days. Help us to walk through these days of preparation with such keen remembrance of what Jesus means to us, or could mean to us. Through him we pray, amen.
Shall we all rise? Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, praise his name. Proclaim his salvation day after day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous deeds among all peoples.
For great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Splendor and majesty are before him. Strength and glory are in his sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, O families of nations. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. Tremble before him, all the earth.
Come, let us worship the Lord.
Let us sing as the angels have sung of the coming of our Lord. In the highest, and on earth, peace.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all the nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. Hail and joy.
there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God, angels that we have heard on high.
Thank you. by the birth of thy Son, Jesus Christ, has given us great light to dawn on our darkness. Grant us that as we welcome our Redeemer, his presence may shed abroad in our hearts and in our homes the light of heavenly peace and joy. Help us to celebrate this season in humility and gratitude, in selfish love and cheerful service, and that it may be a blessing to our souls, a benefit to those around us, and a thanksgiving to thee, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Shall we all be seated and prepare ourselves for our prayer?
Before we pray, may I request the family who are complete, no, to please stand. Ang family lang ang kompleto, gid ara ang nanay, ara tatay, kabataan ara kompleto. Will you please stand? Ati kung makasawa lang kamo kagway kamo bata, ati complete ng kamo, no? You can also stand. Okay. I see Pastor Ruth may gift na karong ihatag sa inyo, no? Okay, shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for the beautiful gift that you've given us, the gift of family, which strengthens us together. You have a lot of beautiful things and plans for our family. That's why you have established them. And this morning, we're so grateful that we can gather together to celebrate your goodness through this family. And we're so grateful for the family who are here, especially for those who are complete. But we also are thankful for the families that have been faithful in serving you, although some of them have been serving you in some other ways, in different areas and different places. Lord, we just pray that you continue to strengthen our families. Continue to unite them. Give them peace and joy as they continue to discern your plans for their life. Lord, I pray that you put a hedge around them as protection from the enemy who's trying to put a wedge in between our families. Those who are trying to destroy our families. Lord, we just pray that you protect our families. Lord, we know that none of the families here are exempted from troubles and from testings and from problems. But we are so grateful that you are a good God, a refuge in times of trouble, and we can come to you and ask for help. So right now, Lord, our Heavenly Father, I pray that you continue to bless our families, especially with unity. Bless them, Lord, with the heart to truly forgive and also to reach out to ask for forgiveness to maintain this unity. I pray, Lord, that you bring about reconciliation in our families, especially for the emotional and relational problems. also continue to provide for the needs. Continue to help them discern your will in their life. And help them, Lord, give them strength to follow this plan for their life. I pray that this Christmas season will be a great joy for them, even as they celebrate together your goodness. Thank you for sending your only begotten Son. Thank you for allowing Jesus to leave his throne in glory just to be with us and introduce us to you. Lord, thank you that through him we can have forgiveness of our sins, we can have our redemption. I pray, Lord, that even as we continue to celebrate Christmas, even as we continue to declare your goodness, Lord, I pray that your name will truly be blessed and honored. Help us to declare with our family, with the kind of life that we live, the good news of salvation to other people. I pray that you continue to bless our incoming programs, our Pamaskwa this afternoon. I pray that you will give us an opportunity to reach out and to bless the people in our community, and also prepare their hearts even as they listen to your word. Even give them the opportunity to respond to you by receiving you as their Lord and Savior. I also pray that you bless our other programs and worship services this coming or this week and the week that follows. I also pray that you bless our worship this morning. I pray that you prepare our hearts as we listen to your word. I pray that you anoint your servant, Pastor Chris, even as you use him as your mouthpiece to bring to us your message. May your name be truly honored and glorified. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never
Shall we all stand again for the reading of the word? I am reading from Luke chapter 1, verses 46 and 47. And Mary said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior." Please be seated.
On a journey that led so far.
Morning, everyone. Today we are celebrating Family Sunday. Let us not forget that Christmas is celebrating the birth of Jesus, our Savior. Our humble Savior became flesh and dwelt among us. He was born of a woman and became part of a human family. Like any human being that walked on earth, the family of Jesus, members of his family are a bunch of normal, imperfect human beings, just like any member of our respective families. But through that family, the whole creation was blessed. Because according to the hymn that we sang a while ago, God, you know, God gave us Christian home. Ang isa gito ka line nga nag-impress ako is, if Christ is the center of our life and our family, truly God can use our respective families to bring about blessings to our own sphere of influence. What causes us to rejoice exceedingly? Well, we can think of so many reasons. Our text says that Mary became exceedingly glad that she exclaimed, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior." So ano ayan ang nag-spark yung sadtong mabaskog na emotion, that strong, very strong emotion of joy kay Mary? So let us revisit this story. Mary was very young when the announcement of her pregnancy happened. I mentioned that during the cantata, that she was probably 15 or 16 years old. Very young. It was not uncommon, however, for women to marry young during those times. Sa subong siguro daw makibot ikaw ko nang imo bata nga nag-edad 15 or 16, mamba nga nay, tay, mama, nanak ko. Oh, basi matambling ka. Oh. Pero during those times, it was not uncommon for women to marry young, or even men to marry young. Because the Jewish people consider building a family very important during those times. Kag sa mga babae, motherhood is one of the topmost priorities for them. So we can say that Mary was already ready for marriage. She was already engaged to be married to a man named Joseph. And I read a beautiful article that explores Mary's thoughts on her engagement with Joseph. And I quote, "At night, Mary starts to imagine living under one roof with Joseph. She tries to picture, or to picture out how she would arrange the furniture. And she is grateful that Joseph is a carpenter and he could make the things they could not afford to buy. And then, she dreams of children. Little Mary and Joseph's running around the house. And she starts to pray, 'Lord, make me as fruitful as Leah and beloved like Rachel. Let me live long enough to see my children's children.'" A simple and meaningful dream of a woman about to marry the man of her dreams. And all of a sudden,
This is a familiar story to all of us, repeated time and again. All of a sudden, there was a major shift in her story. The angel announced that she would be pregnant of her firstborn son. And there was a specific instruction. You will name him Jesus because he will save his people from their sins. According to the story, when the announcement was made, Mary was terrified. Terrified. Kung ikaw man ba may, you know, walang nakabalos ang tsura sing angel. But there was something supernatural in the nature of the announcement. So as a young woman, according to the scriptures, Mary was so scared, she was terrified, that the angel said, fear not, fear not. Hindi ka magkahadlo. She was terrified not only because of the supernatural nature of the announcement, but maybe because of its implication as well. You know what? The betrothal stage during those times was so binding that if in any event that Joseph died, Mary would be declared a widow. Amo na kabinding sang ilang betrothal stage during those times. And you know what? When she, ang isa ka implication, when she was found out to be pregnant, especially if Joseph denies the paternity of the child, according to the Jewish law, pwede siya nga sentensyahan to be publicly stoned to death. Death sentence. Not by hanging or lethal injection, but stoning. Masakit-sakit man niya kamatayon. Granting that she will not be put to death, there is a tendency that she will be the object of gossip. And Joseph might also cancel the marriage. Kag amog ito yataning imuon ni Joseph. He actually wanted to leave Mary to cancel the engagement. But he was an honorable man. He wanted to do it secretly, not to put Mary in public disgrace. He was an honorable man. So if not for the intervention of God, binayaan niya si Mary. Subot silingon, the announcement was very scary on the part of Mary from a human perspective. But Mary, upon realizing that all of the things that are happening to her are all part of God's great plan, she responded in obedience despite her difficulty in understanding everything. She said, I am the Lord's maid servant. Be it unto me according to your word. I am the Lord's maid servant. Be it unto me according to your word. In effect, Mary was saying, Lord, I am at your disposal. Whatever pleases you, do it to me. Ang ining exclamation ni Mary happened when she visited her cousin Elizabeth. When the angel announced to Mary that she is pregnant, the angel mentioned that her cousin Elizabeth, who was already declared barren and impossible to conceive because of old age, is 6 months pregnant. And the angel said, because with God, nothing is impossible. So Mary visited her and stayed there for 3 months on a hill country in Judah. So masiling naton nga medyo bulubukid jutay, nami ang setting, green siguro kag manami ang hangin. So she went there on a hill country in Judah. Maybe because she wanted to ascertain if what the angel told her was true. Tuodayhan, nagabusong si Elizabeth. And perhaps she also needed to go out of her constricting situation. according to the biblical account in Luke chapter 1, in those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country to a town of Judah, and she entered the house of Zechariah. Zechariah is the husband of Elizabeth, and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the sound of your greeting came to my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy." Si John the Baptist, kuno na, siguro nag-trampoline dito sa sulod, no? When he heard the voice of Mary, Elizabeth felt that the baby leapt for joy inside her womb. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior." Siyang pagsiling niya, "My soul," in Greek, "suki," literally means breath, you know, meaning my innermost being, "doth magnify" is a rendering of Greek megalono. It means to enlarge, to make great, to show, to be big. Now, "my soul doth magnifies the Lord." It means to be exceedingly grateful. My whole being magnifies the Lord. Ang buhay kasi sinusilingon na to make God bigger than what He already is, but to recognize His greatness, His goodness, to magnify Him. Tikita nagapati kita nga ang Diyos dako gamhanan, pero damo nga tao wala nag-ascribe honor and glory to Him. But this time, Mary said, my whole being magnifies the Lord, gives Him honor and glory that is due to Him. Tempamangkot, what gripped Mary's whole being? May duwa lang ako ka rason nga ang nagpasalamat gitudo nga nag kalipay gid si Mary nga masiling kita ang my innermost being, but silingon ang kalipay puwerte gid tuman gid niya kalipay. Ano ang nagtulod sa iya sa pag ano, ang scriptures nga kasiling, she was filled with the Holy Spirit, that she was exceedingly joyful. Ano ang nagtulod sa iya? Duha lang ka rason na nakita ko diri sa text nga ato nga ginbasa kagina. Number one. Ana. Okay. Wara na siya. Tuga katulugan ng ato nga projector. Ang iya nga ginkalipay, she felt the nearness of God. You know what? There is so much beauty in Mary's language. As a matter of fact, ang imbasa, takagina, hindi lang ito yan nagambal sa yung "my soul magnifies the Lord." According to the scripture, it was a song. Okay? She sang a song. Ang title sang yung kanta sa Latin, Magnificat. Munang title, no? Hindi Christmas in our hearts. Magnificat ang title. No? "My soul magnifies the Lord." This is actually a song. And there is so much beauty in the language of Mary's song here. "My soul magnifies the Lord." Look at the language. "My soul magnifies or glorifies Jehovah." And then the second verse, "and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. In that underline, not together, I underlined it, my Savior. You know, the first sentence is a bit distant. My soul glorifies Jehovah. But the second phrase says, my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. It becomes very intimate. My Savior. I rejoice over God, my Savior. The conversation between Mary and Elizabeth before this verse is centered on one person, the Messiah in Mary's womb. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, and blessed is he who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord. And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. My friends, Mary may have not grasped the whole picture here. For me, hindi pa siya kinsindi, basahan niyo lang Luke chapter 1. She asked, how can this be? I am a virgin. I've never been with a man. How can I be pregnant? Hindi niya maintindihan ang proseso sang Diyos. Pero ang angel nagamba siya, with God, nothing is impossible. And she was silenced. And she believed that. And she submitted herself. Sila niya, okay, be it unto me according to your word. Mary may have not grasped the whole picture here, but she understood one thing essential, that the baby in her womb is a long-awaited Savior of the world, the one that has been prophesied for many generations back. This baby is the light of the world. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. She did not say, my spirit rejoices in my son. But she said, my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. This baby in her womb will save his people from their sins. As what the angels, or what the angel Gabriel told her. She was exceedingly glad. Not so much because she was the one chosen, but because salvation has finally come. And that she is being an instrument. She was used as an instrument in bringing about the fulfillment of God's prophecy. As a matter of fact, after sine, si Zechariah ko, no? Zechariah also prophesied. Kaya prophecy, almost the same sa ginambal ni Mary, blessed be the God of Israel, for he has visited us and accomplished redemption for his people, and has raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of David, his servant, as he spoke by the mouth of his holy prophets of old, sila ni Zechariah, salvation from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us, to show mercy toward our fathers, and to remember by his holy covenant. And he said, because of the tender mercy of God, with which the sunrise from on high will visit us, to shine upon those who sit in darkness and the shadow of death, to guide our feet in the way of peace. But silingon, ang pag-abot sang Messiah, Jesus, made them feel the nearness of God. That God became Emmanuel, God with us. Sang una, no? Sang wala pa mag-abot, they were asking, san o ayan? When? When is the fulfillment of the prophecy? But this time, they can say, my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. Because finally, God the Father fulfilled his covenant with his people. Preaching on a Christmas morning, almost 500 years ago, Martin Luther reminded his congregation that the proper response to the Christian or the Christmas story is not mere rejoicing nor casual interest, but faith. Luther reminded his congregation that most persons know how to rejoice when they are given a Christmas gift. Hindi ba? Sila niya, how many are those who shout and jump for joy when they receive a gift? Hindi ba damo sa ito nga nagkakalipay, Jed? No? May nakita ko sa isa kadlaw nga, hindi ko lang pagyamba, pero ginregaluan dyan sa iya nga fiancé, isang iPhone 7 nga waterproof nga katahom, Jed. Latest, Jed ko, no? Baka pilagid siya magambal, OMG, OMG, no? But sila nga, lipay, Jed siya. Oo, gasinggit-singgit, Jed siya. We love, sila niya, we rejoice, ambali Martin Luther. But how many are there who shout and jump for joy when they hear the message of the angel? To you is born this day a Savior. Sila niya, indeed, the majority look upon it as a sermon that must be preached. Sulit-sulit. But sila niya, when they have heard it, consider it a trifling thing and go away just as they were before. This shows that we have neither, sila niya, believed as Luther understood, to hear the Christmas story and to respond with mere interest is an indication of faith absence. Furthermore, Luther helpfully reminded his congregation that a mere affirmation of the fact that the incarnation occurred is not a saving faith. Sila niya, we do not believe that the Virgin Mother bore a son and that he is the Lord and Savior unless, added to this, I believe the second thing, namely, that he is my Savior, my Lord. In other words, Martin Luther said, the message of Christmas is received when Jesus Christ is not merely affirmed as the baby in Bethlehem's manger, but as one's own Savior and Lord. Siling niya, I quote, when I can say, this I accept as my own because the angel meant it for me, then if I believe in my heart, I shall not fail to love the child and the Heavenly Father. For if it is true that the child was born of the Virgin and is mine, then I have no angry God, and I must know and feel that there is nothing but laughter and joy in the heart of the Father, and no sadness in my heart. For if what the angel says is true, that he is our Lord and Savior, Selene Martin Luther, what can sin do against me? This is the source of Mary's jubilation. The once promised Messiah, who will be the Savior of the world, became a living reality to Mary. And when she exclaimed, my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, she allowed God to take over the course of her life. Be it unto me according to your word. But that's what it meant to have Christ as our Savior, to let him have dominion over our own will, over our own life. But you know what? That is the mystery of the kingdom of God. It is a great paradox. If you lose your life for the sake of Christ, you will find it. Mary became blessed. All generation will call her blessed. Why? Because she has given the chance to bear and rear the Son of the Most High God. Katahumblas ang kabuhi ni Mary. Si Mary, it's a derivative of the Hebrew name Miriam. Ang literal meaning si Miriam, bitter. I read two sources that defined the Hebrew name Miriam as rebellion.
rebellion. But in this, pagambas ang Ginoo nga gamiton ta ka, ang espiritu ni Mary was submission. Amo ning bukalugan sa Christmas, submission. Unless we fail to submit our whole being to God, if He is not the center of our life, di makasiling kita nga, wala naton mag-grasp ang esensya sa Christmas. God is near. Second, and last, duwa lang. Do hindi tapi. Ang feelings ang naton, do hindi baptist, kung duwa lang eh. Kaya ang baptist, pero may nga pastor, tatlo git. Oh. So, duwa lang yung ako na. Okay. Nearness of God. Ikaduwa nga din celebrar ni Mary. Nearness of family. Family Sunday. Nearness of family. After the announcement, the attempt of Joseph to abandon Mary, it might have been a rough ride for Mary. Grabe nang kalatapo siya, she was only 15 or 16. She was at the center of God's plan, and she, ang pamangkot, did she understand all this? Hardly. She asked the question, how can this be? She was baffled. Perhaps she heard some whispers behind her back. Tugad ako ang buyo ni Maryaw. Wala pa man na sila makasal. You know, aram na sa barangay te. Maybe she heard some rumors regarding her pregnancy. And so according to the story, she hurried to the hill country to be with her cousin Elizabeth because perhaps she longed for peace and quiet. Elizabeth was also troubled with all that had been happening to her. Si Elizabeth may ara man niya problema. She became pregnant when human understanding says she was past beyond her years. Basi dali na lang siya mang pangayo discount 20% sa Jollibee. No? Basi may ID na to. SS, senior citizen. Pero nagbusong pa. Kaya ang basang scriptures, wait takabalo kung pila edad niya, but she was past beyond her years. So hindi niya maintindihan na nagkalatabo siya. And you know what? Her husband was struck dumb. Read the account. Hindi kambal ang yabana. He could not speak. But when they met, saan niyo ba ang account yet? When they met, they leapt for joy over the presence of one another. They became a community to one another. Their nearness to each other caused both women to realize their gifts. The mother of my Lord, cries Elizabeth. My soul magnifies the Lord, cries Mary. Elizabeth understands, affirms, and celebrates, her whole body jubilant. And Mary realizes her grace, her gift, her special blessing. And with a newfound freedom coming from a newfound perspective, ang tanang nagkalatabo sa iya, suno sa plano sang Diyos, she exclaims, my soul magnifies the Lord. He has looked with favor on the lowliness of His servant. Surely from now on, all generations shall call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Two women who felt oppressed and isolated suddenly realize their greatness and are free to celebrate their blessings. The two of them became a community. They need each other just to be together, to protect each other,
to support each other and affirm each other. And you know what? After 3 months, they separated because they felt that each of them is now ready to face their respective circumstances without fear, willing to suffer the consequences of their respective pregnancies and motherhood. Thinking about the visitation, Henry Nouwen wrote a beautiful reflection. And listen to this. Henry Nouwen said, "I can hardly think about a better way to understand friendship, care, and love, and family than the way of the visitation. In a world so full of shame and guilt, we need to visit each other, to offer each other a safe place where we can claim our freedom and celebrate our gifts. We need to get away once in a while from the suspicious voices and angry looks and be in a place where we are deeply understood and loved. Then we might be able to face the hostile world again without fear and with a new trust in our integrity." I hope this reflection will cause us to appreciate and be grateful for the presence of our family. Hindi perfecto ang aton mga pamilya. Siguro kada pamilya may ara gid nga mga hang-ups. May problema. Bisan pamilya ni Jesus. But you know the mystery. The centrality of Christ not only in our individual lives, but family life as well, will cause us to be a family member God wants us to be. Loving, compassionate, forgiving, generous. With the presence of Jesus Christ in each member of our family will be a safe haven for each one of us, where home becomes a place where shortcomings are forgiven, gifts are affirmed, and blessings are shared. And let us not forget, my friends, in closing, that we are a family in this church. Basta ara ang Christian community, I believe it is a family bound together not by blood, but by our allegiance to the same Lord and Savior. My Savior, my Lord is also your Savior, your Lord. And when each member of the church takes joy and meaning in their relationship with Jesus, our relationship with one another becomes an avenue where we affirm our calling and celebrate our gifts. And the church becomes a home where the weary and heavy laden find rest upon their souls. This morning, before ko magsaka, my friend shared a beautiful song entitled "God Bless Us." And I would like to close in this as my greetings to all of you. When your heart is frozen, when your heart is frozen over from a lifetime of regret, when the scars you wear have hardened into stone, may the spirit of the season come and melt the ice again. Thaw the coldest winter heart and call it home. And if we lose sight of all that we could be, may we stumble to the one who makes us see. Amen.
As we celebrate this Christmas season, let us be reminded of our share in the advance of God's kingdom. We all have something to share. The miracles of the 5,000 people fed with five fish is an example of how God meets needs we haven't even yet anticipated. When Jesus and the 12 started preaching, they had no plans to feed the 5,000. Yet, when the time came, they had enough to provide for all. As we share our offerings this morning, let's think of how our gifts will enable the church to meet the needs of others, and how, by sharing our resources today, we can ensure that the church is ready to meet the needs of tomorrow. Let us give our tithes, pledges, and offerings.
Generous God, in this season of love and giving, we can never outgive you. Like the child who came to save us, we seek to grow in wisdom in your favor. Guide us in the offering of our resources of time, talent, and wealth. Help us to grow in faith as those who reflect a glimpse of your extravagant generosity. Lead us into the Christmas celebration that we may seek you and be pleasing in your sight and bring glory to you and to your Son. In your glorious name we pray. Amen.
Okay, you may be seated. Now for opportunities for service. No? But again, we would like to remind you that this coming December 24, we will have a worship service at 6 o'clock in the evening. No? And then the next day, January 25, we will have a joint worship. 25 is Sunday. No? We will have a joint worship at 9:30. There will be no early morning worship, the 7 o'clock worship. But we'll have a joint worship at 9:30, and we will also have a Vesper service. The same thing will happen also on December 31. We have our traditional New Year's Eve worship at 6 o'clock in the evening. And then the next day, January 1, we will also have our joint communion worship service. So please take note of this schedule. This afternoon we'll have our Pamaskwa. No, so there's a reason for all the bags that we have here. Thank you, no, for your generosity. Ang inyong mga white gift, the white gift of the university, amo iningin pang ripak and to be shared to the people in the community who are very needy. No, please include us in our prayers that our time together with them will be something that is meaningful, even as we give them the opportunity to listen to the gospel and to respond to the gospel. No? Also, please include in your prayers, no, the family of my wife, no, Marisa Kim po, ang iyang father, nagpass away kay inasang aga. And in this hour of bereavement, please include them in your prayers. No? So, after karon sa kaagahon, I will, together with my two children, makadtuman kami dito na. And then, Pastor Ruth, may surprise. No? Okay, may surprise si Pastor Ruth.
It is our family Sunday, and God has given us the gift of family. And praise God, we have 16 family present, complete family members. And I please, will you please stand as I call the names of your family? Just the family, please stand. You will receive a fruit cocktail. Madero family, please stand. Banyas family. Dr. John T. Kimpo family. Faraon family. Herga family. Bachoco family. Tikar family. Magbanwa family. Sonsa family. Fel. Saho family, Abilardi family, Paul and Joy Imbang family, Limbungan family, Hannah Burao family, and Parkon family. God is so good. We are blessed with this family. Shall we give them a hand? You will receive a fruit cocktail for your, ano yung tawag na? Medianoche. Okay, thank you.
Rise as we sing our closing hymn, as we are reminded that we are the reason for this Christmas.
As little children, we dream of Christmas.
today, and now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Take the right direction. Savior.